I got your picture, I'm coming with you. Dear Maria, count me in. There's a story at the bottom of this bottle, and I'm a pair.
Will from the Subtle Knight, his Dark Materials trilogy by Philip Pullman. He's not just my current.
Godzilla.
Why Godzilla?
Because he's Godzilla.
Why not?
That's awesome. All right, what
kind of
you?
Impression is that?
My favorite film crush is Snape. And your dad's
I know
like,
he's a bad boy,
right.
But yeah. I think I should probably turn around. I could change him and make him back.
I love Snape. I have a pillow of Snape, and I visit him every night.
A Snape pillow.
Yeah.
Captain America.
Wow, that was like not even a hesitation right
none
there.
None at all.
Why Captain America?
Because he's played by Chris Evans, and Chris Evans is really hot. No, and also he has, he is very moral, he's very upstanding, and he is the hero. He's never been an anti-hero. He's just, you know, good guy all around.
I would say my current fictional crush, and this is because I spent a lot of time with him over the past 4 years, is Oliver from a book I have coming out next year.
Okay.
And I got to know him really well, and I spent a lot of time with him, and I really want to meet him in person so I can apologize for all the things that I put him through in the book. And I also just want to ask him some questions.
Okay.
I don't want to say what the questions are, but I have some questions for Oliver that I don't have answers for yet. So.
I'm going to say the Darkling in the Grisha series.
Oh my god.
So wonderfully. Yeah. It's time for dinner.
Fictional crush would have to be Travis Thomas from Noggin. He is the cutest and the sweetest and he's hilarious.
Well, I will say that I sort of have a crush on Redeeming's character Ted Campbell in Kissing Ted Campbell. And the reason he is crushable is because he's not like the standard hunk who has all the confidence and knows exactly what he's kind of a dork.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that, that was the type of guy that I liked.
Yeah.
With a little bit of a dork, a little bit of a sweet guy. So he's definitely a contender.
Uh-huh.
And her book comes out next year through Poppy, part of Little Brown.
Yeah.
So he's definitely on the list.
Okay.
My fictional crush is Raylan Givens from the TV show Justified. He is awesome.
Okay, I'm totally embarrassed to say this, but it's actually a character in the sequel that I've written to a girl called Fearless. So I'm embarrassed, but he is so cute. I mean, really, really adorable.
My current fictional crush. I just started reading this book called Half Bad. Maybe some of you have read it. I'm not very far into it, but I'm really liking the protagonist's voice. He's completely gripping. Sally Green, I think, is the author.
Tim Riggins has been my fictional crush since Friday Night Lights.
Yes!
Which I feel like is, I had to really think about that answer, but I think that one is pretty solid. One that I won't regret.
Hi, I'm Jessica Brody, author of Unremembered. My current fictional crush is King Edward from The White Queen, which I am just finishing right now, and it's awesome, and he is dreamy.
There are a lot of them, but I think that beautiful pictures probably would have meant a lot to me when I was in middle school, and I felt like I was like totally misunderstood by everyone in my school, and lived in small with other suburbs. So I think that probably would have done me a lot of good.
The Realm of Possibility by David Levithan. That's what made me want to start really writing YA. It was recommended to me by Rachel Cohen, and it's a phenomenal book, and I loved it, and I still have a copy, and I look at it every so often on my shelf when I pick it back up, and I think, oh, this book is still as good as it was. So I just wish I had read it 10 years ago.
Book I wish I had when I was a teen would definitely be Twilight. Twilight is the book that got me into young adult literature. and those kinds of books just didn't exist when I was a teen. So I feel like if they had existed, I would have read a lot more as a teen.
I guess, listen, you are a teen, so it's a little different. So what book are you grateful that you have now as a teen?
I am grateful for The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak.
Okay, there's a few, but I think one comes to mind right now, The Absolutely True Diary of a Part-Time Indian. That book is amazing, and I love it now, and I would have eaten that up in a week.
Books I wish I had when I was a teenager would have to be Sarah Dessen, because I didn't discover her until my 20s. So.
Oh. All of them.
I was a teen a long time ago. I would say I really wish I had had the Italian series by Megan Whalen-Turner. I love it.
I wish I had had Hunger Games.
Hunger Games.
You know? I mean, because I think that book asks such powerful questions about what you would do if you were in the same situation. And so that is the one I wish I had.
By Mariah Fredericks, who's a contemporary realistic author I really admire. And this story was about a boy and a girl who live in the same apartment building. And they start doing some sort of like role playing after school. And she's kind of getting over an incident from her past that he helps her with. They wouldn't normally have been friends, but they're sort of drawn together. And I just thought that would have been a really cool read when I was a teenager.
The book that I wish that I would have had, I did have, which is The Giver, which I first read in sixth grade and have remembered the feeling that it gave me ever since.
Okay, Deep Tranquility by Katya Millay. I wish I had that version, that type of love story.
Grasshopper Jungle by Andrew Smith.
Great choice!
It's an awesome book. Yeah.